Today we've gathered all possible kinds of winter vehicles that have one common characteristic. Their price is less than $2,000. And we are going to find out what machine is the most effective in winter. Let's go! Hi guys, as usual it's me, just a voiceover, and you are watching Review Machines. When we are speaking about winter transport, we usually mean only sleds, don't we? Yes, probably they are best kind of winter transport, but as to their prices, well, they leave much to be desired. The most affordable used sleds may cost about $5,000, and new snowmobiles of famous brands will cost you an arm and a leg. But in fact, there are other kinds of winter transport with much more affordable prices. And today we gathered almost all kinds of such vehicles that cost only about $2,000. Numerous manufacturers from different places have come today to take part in this grand battle. And first of all, we want to thank him greatly for that. Well, let's see what we have today for our tests. The most part of these machines are so-called snow dogs. It's a great winter transport, both recreational and for everyday use. We've already made a video about these machines, we spoke about all the details there, so have a look at it if you missed it. Well, today firstly we have a classic snow dogs with the sleds. Then we have a snow dogs equipped with a front seat, like a snowmobile. And finally we have several 2x2 motorcycles, that are also considered as a real winter transport. Moreover, we'll see other different modifications of winter transport, so it's going to be interesting. And now let's see what models take part in this battle today. HP front seat sled BTS, 15 HP front seat sled BTS, same machine with other seat, Burak front seat, 15 HP front seat Muhta, 17 HP Mujik, Lebedev garage 15 HP, Sigma front seat 8 HP, Balt Motors snow dog 15 HP, Balt Motors standard 13 HP, Koira 15 HP. While we are having the last preparations, I want to speak in a word about the forthcoming tests. As we have many machines today, we'll arrange only two tests, cause we want to see all the machines in action. The first competition, who is the fastest? And the second one, who is the most effective on rough terrain? Well, and now let's have a speed race competition. All the competitors are standing in the line and waiting for the signal. For the first time, all the machines are going to take part in the race. But you should remember that everything doesn't depend on a machine, skills of a rider are also very important. The short briefing before the race, and it seems that we are ready. Go! Burak front seat shows a very good start. But then the others catch up with him. After the turning around, we see three leaders. All of them are snow dogs from Balt Motors company. Then we will have several pair competitions. The first one, Balt Motors vs Burak. As we see, Balt Motors overtakes its competitor. The next race, Muhtar vs 15 HP white snow dog. This time we have a draw. Then again, Bolt Motors vs. Burak. Burak chose the wrong way, so the result is not clear. Another race, this time four competitors, Burak and three Snow Dogs from BTS. And BTS is the winner. And finally another mass race. And again, Bolt Motors is the winner. Well, now it's time for the next test, riding on rough terrain. The route is quite short, it has two climbs, first one is short, but step, and another is longer. Here we see the line, the competitors will take part in the test one after another. We are ready, let's go! Burak from seat is the first. Well done, it gets over without a problem. Mukhtar from seat is the next one. It also overcomes our obstacles. Now a small classic snowmobile is trying. Unfortunately, it fails on the second hill. The next one is a Snow Dog Raider. And again, it has some problems on the second hill. The same thing with the Bolt Motors Snow Dog. In fact, all the Snow Dogs with LEDs behind the machines fail it on this obstacle. Then we see a 2x2 motorcycle Master Pro. A perfect result. Then Taurus 2x2 motorcycle. And again the perfect result. Now we see BTS front seat Snow Dog. Again the second hill. Sigma front seat Snow Dog. Well, good result. By the way, it was interesting for us to see a rear-wheel drive off-road and motorcycle on this hill. And the result is on your screens. Well, due to this test we can make a conclusion that front seat Snow Dogs are more effective on rough terrain than classic Snow Dogs with LEDs behind them. The good result on the hills was shown by 2x2 motorcycles, but on a speed test they were the last. So you've seen everything, all the machines have both pros and cons, so it's very hard to choose a complete winner of our battle. But I hope this video will be quite useful for those who are going to buy some kind of winter transport. By the way, we want to make some more videos about this topic, so if you want a sequel, please pass the comment. What do you think, if we should make more videos like this or not? What kind of machines and tests should we add? Well, thanks for watching guys, please subscribe the channel if you like this video, it will be many more interesting materials here, goodbye!
This is a Chucky Beat production.